very large delegation will come from the newspaper passing to the TV. I was so glad to say that they accepted already to receive them and discuss about the relationship between the two countries. And we are so glad also that the Chamber of Commerce, it's, let's say, the house of the private sector, the institution is making the middle between the government and the private sector. And we hope that we will concentrate on that issue. And if you can ask the question that you would like to know and you're ready to respond.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. My name is Andualem Sisa. I represent the Nation Media Group of Kenya in Ethiopia, and I also run an online publication called newbusinessethiopia.com. My question is about business relations that you have with your counterpart, Chamber of Ethiopia or Chamber of Addis, and the specific collaboration areas that you are looking for to work together, or any partnership that you look in the future, or any kind of business ties between Ethiopia and Djibouti. Thank you.
Thank you for your question. Concerning the relationship between the two chambers, Ethiopian Chamber of Commerce and Djibouti Chamber of Commerce, we have a very strong and very long-term relationship since long time. And the new board members who were elected, I already congratulate them. We don't meet each other, but we hope to invite them soon because we are organizing a regional meeting in Djibouti for IGAD Business Forum. And Mrs. Solomon, who was the previous president of Chamber of Commerce of Ethiopia, we met each other in Hong Kong in Commerce's meeting. We hope to redynamize or reactivate our relationship that, between the two Chamber of Commerce. And we know the two business community are very strong in this country. It's very important also the institutions must follow all this linked between the two communities. And how we say Ethiopia is our best city and very strong neighbor country that we are making. We are serving also them as a logistic country. We want to re-dynamize and keep very strong relation between the two chambers because we have to even see each other for the next meeting that we have in Djibouti to sign again some agreement that we already have got in Djibouti and Ethiopia. We have to reorganize or reconsider some of the issues, some articles.
Are there any specific business areas that you want to collaborate with in terms of regional integration, economic integration, or whatever?
The regional integration, if I come back on the IGAD Business Forum, it's a forum that it's organized every 2 years by one country hosted. Last time it was, I think, in Uganda. And now it will be, I think, on February. We already fixed the date. We already sent invitation for business communities and business chamber of commerce in Addis Ababa last month. We will organize the 14th and 16th February 2015 in Djibouti, the IGAD Business Forum. That IGAD Business Forum will be, let's say, a forum that we will discuss as integration between the region. The country, the seven countries in the IGAD, will share ideas. We'll also develop the agreement that we already signed to create that forum. You will be also most invited and welcome to be invited on this meeting because it's very important for the integration of the region. The specific point that we will discuss is already mentioned to the agenda. It will be integration, it will be how we can serve the countries between IGAD business forum, how we can develop also and to make strong relationship between the business communities in logistics, in services, in business import, export, and even industrial. We have many issues that we will talk together. But you will be most welcome on that meeting because it's very important also for your information to be a part of us.
Yes, I will go ahead.
As we see in our tour, now Djibouti is mentioning the era of trade and industrial free zones, something like this. More focus about regulations on the issue of foreign investments or even private, the issue of privatization or private sector regulation in Djibouti that is going to attract more investment in the coming era for free zones and industrial zones. Also, the Ethiopian-Djibouti relations as a model for neighboring countries, model in the region. Would you like to make more or particular or special regulation for Ethiopian business in Djibouti related to the special relation between Ethiopia and Djibouti? Thank you.
Thank you for your question. I think that in this fact, you know that Djibouti and Ethiopia have got a very long relation, a strong relation, I would say. And that relation keeps that Djibouti and Ethiopia's business communities was considered since 2006, the last agreement signed by the previous Prime Minister, Bahadura, means that an investor, a Djiboutian investor, if you want to invest in Ethiopia, it will be considered as an Ethiopian. An Ethiopian investor is considered as a Djiboutian investor. This is, I think, nobody can, no other country is making this kind of strong agreement. Except, I think, in Ethiopia, Djiboutian cannot invest in banking, insurance, and the third was in the pharmaceutical.
Telecom, maybe? Telecom, maybe?
Telecommunication is already closed from two countries. Huh? Mm-hmm. It's a unique, let's say, it's the government who's controlling. Telecommunication, we cannot invest because we have got laws saying that for Djibouti and for Ethiopia, that is the government who will regulate and who will make their business. But except these three items, three let's say articles, three what I can say, the
items,
points. Yeah. The rest, Djiboutian and Ethiopian can invest in the two sides,
including transport.
Including transport, because Ethiopians, what I know, Ethiopians are investing some of the businessmen. Ethiopian businessmen have got Ethiopian Djiboutian tax, Djibouti matriculated tax. Some of them, they invested through Djibouti. We know that also some Chinese are also investing on the tax in the transportation activities. And you see some Djiboutian tax considered as an investment of Djiboutian who will go to Ethiopia. It's really very important that only two countries was made, and you know that electricity. No other countries in Africa was made this connection between Ethiopia and Djibouti. That's why we said it's very strong relation that you have to fulfill and follow.